let me inform the House that there is a 0-hour notice tabled by Sri Adalbert Nongrum, MLA, under Rule 49A of the Rules of Procedure and Conduct of Business to the news item published in Mauport, dated 31st December 2023, under the caption T43 Clur Pundonkam Bakla Ka Health Department Ban Yakum COVID Dispersing. Sri Adalbert Nongrum, MLA, please.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker, sir, for allowing me to raise a matter of grave importance on the rules 49A of the Rules of Procedure and Conduct of Business. The matter relates to a new item which appeared in Mauport on dated 31st January 2023 under the caption Saukulai Kulur Tingka Penokam Bakla Ka Health Department Ban Yakun COVID. The same news item also appeared in Ulongsan Hima on the same date under the caption Saupulai Kulur Tingka Bam Kulok Ka Sorkar Jala Nakapisa COVID Ka Sorkar Pring. Mr. Speaker, sir, I only request for clarification from the Health Minister to the particular matter of grave importance, which I shall specifically draw attention. During the last Assembly session, that is Autumn Session 2022, I had put a start question to the government on dated 12 September 2022 regarding amount spent on COVID-19 till date. And with reference to the total amount spent from the centre, the reply from the Health Minister was ₹76.56 crores. Now, we see from the news item that has been raised in this zero-hour matter that the RTI finding by one dispassing Rani, one of the RTI activists, which he received from the CPIO, NHM, Finance Division, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Government of India, that central release of grants in AIDS through NHM under India COVID-19 Emergency Response and Health System Preparedness Package for State of Meghalaya was ₹15.621 crore in Phase 1 and ₹104.12 crore in Phase 2. I'm not aware of COVID-19 activities continuing in the state after dated 12 September 2022. I may repeat again. I am not aware of COVID-19 activities continuing in the state after dated 12 September 2022. Therefore, as a member of this August House, it is my parliamentary privilege to be given the correct information and not to mislead. So, Mr. Speaker, sir, through this zero-hour matter, I ask how the amount of money spent from central government on COVID-19 activities in Meghalaya can be officially declared in the State Legislative Assembly for an amount lower than what is declared by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Government of India, in an RTI. I am very rightful to know the fact, because we are representing this August House, representing the voice of the people of the state at large would like to know the fact. With just these few words, Mr. Speaker, sir, I resume my seat.
Yes, Minister in charge, would you like, please?
Honourable Speaker, sir, at the outset, I would like to thank Ma Ethelbert Longbrook, Honourable Member from North Shillong constituency, for calling attention on this topic through Rule 49A. During the COVID pandemic, I would like to clarify to the August House the following facts. During the COVID pandemic period, Union of India, through Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, had come up with an emergency COVID response package to support the efforts of state in its efforts towards fighting COVID. The package was accorded to Meghalaya in two phases, viz. ECRP Phase 1, ECRP Phase 2. This was funded through the National Health Mission. ECRP Phase 1 is 100% centrally funded head, whereas ECRP Phase 2 encapsulates a 90:10 funding pattern between the central and the state government, respectively. ECRP 1 was for the year 2020 to 2021, and ECRP 2 was during 2021 to 2022. The question asked in the Assembly in the autumn session of 2022 was regarding the amount spent from central and state respectively for COVID intervention. Thus, the answer that was mentioned was 76.56 crores in this August House, sir. The RTI filed to the Union Ministry had asked for the amount sanctioned, for which a reply given as on 20th January 2023 was 104.12 crores rupees. I would like to mention that the amount mentioned in the RTI is correct. However, the reply given during the then autumn session was about the money that was spent already. Various works under ECRP 2 are long-term works, the works of which are ongoing. Moreover, the sanction for one major component of the package, that is the critical care block amounting to 21.38 crores, was given much later than that of the other components. The work has just begun for that, and no financial progress has been made so far. Therefore, the amount that has been misunderstood as missing has not been spent and shall be released based on the physical progress of the sanctioned work, sir.